Spotlight on America inside one of only 15 certified helmet reconditioning facilities in the country, doing a critical job when it comes to protecting high school football players. Once helmets have spent a season or two taking hits, it's up to a network of reconditioners like Bob Fawley with Capital Varsity Sports to make sure they're still safe for young athletes.
I mean, it's been scrutinized a dozen times by the time it gets out of the plant.
Bags of helmets come here from high schools all over the Midwest. Then they take a two-week journey, going station by station, where they're examined for cracks, their hardware removed, their guts pulled out, sanitized, and replaced if the padding inside isn't game ready.
How often are those inside pieces being tossed and replaced with something new?
It's quite often. I mean, we spend a lot of money here. A lot of what the schools are paying for are the cost of those liners.
What schools are also paying for is this tiny sticker, a seal from NOCSI, the National Operating Committee on Standards for Athletic Equipment. It says the helmet has been recertified, ready to go back out on the field.
I always want an annual recertified and clean certified helmet on every athlete that's playing.
Tony Beam is executive director of another key group in the helmet refurbishment process, NARA, the National Athletic Equipment Reconditioners Association. Together with NOCSI and the helmet makers, they set the various standards for when helmets should be tossed, how often they should be refurbished, and what that process should look like. But the standards are voluntary, and our Spotlight on America investigation found a lack of uniformity nationwide when it comes to how often helmets are refurbished and how well some schools are tracking maintenance.
Do you feel like the system is working?
The system is there, and I believe it's working correctly. Certainly most, from our experience in NARA, pretty much every high school is doing reconditioning, recertification, at minimum the every other year.
Why not mandate it?
They are required in a way, and that really comes through the NFHS. Certainly, if they're not following their guidelines, I'm sure there are consequences.
Beam is referring to the National Federation of State High School Associations, or NFHS. When we reached out to them, they told us they cannot require schools to use our playing rules, nor can we require schools to adhere to NOCSI NARA standards.
But clearly we want to do better, and we need to do better.
Congressman Don Bacon, co-chairman of the Congressional Brain Injury Task Force, has taken new interest in helmet safety after we told him about the patchwork of voluntary standards we found in our nationwide investigation, raising questions about the need for more formal oversight.
I think we need a standard, and whether it's a federal or state, I'm willing to discuss it and study the pros and cons. We're not going to stop playing the game, but we can surely raise the bar on helmet standards.
For now, reconditioners like Bob Fawley stand behind their helmets. He says testing done on finished products demonstrate the more than 1 million helmets refurbished each year are ready for play.
Oh, I think the parents should feel very confident in this process. No other sport has done anything near what football has done to try to make these things safe.
I'm Josie Sturman for Spotlight on America.